Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Genshin Impact. It is the 16th of August right now. I did not play anything, actually, yesterday. And I have loaded in for the very first time here after 4.0 has released. You know what that means. That's why I've decided to load in. I'm not really sure how long I'm going to play, but we are going to, of course, have a little peek at... Well, obviously, as I had said before, we're going to go and have a peek at the new Fontaine stuff, which I think is going to be very exciting. Before we do that, let me just... Okay, my brain is apparently having issues processing what I wanted to say at the start of this. Brain, click. Clicking. Okay, so let us... Well, first of all, let's look at some of the new stuff. So we got an event... Oh my Jesus Christ. Okay, we've got a lot of stuff noticed on here. We've got an event thing, we've got... a speaking person. This is a new character. Okay. I think invite to wait, you just what? You just get her. What the fuck? There's new stuff, guys. There's new stuff. Yeah, I was told I don't know really anything about Fontaine, because as you would know up to now, I do not watch the previews or trailers or teasers or anything like that, or demos for characters and stuff. Yet, I'm still working on the gumption to start doing that. So really the only thing that I think I know about Fontaine is that is basically stuff that you would learn in the game, that they're like a technologically savvy country, they're French, and that from what I have heard and seen, the characters love wearing hats, very ugly hats at that, and... I'm trying to think if there's anything else that I know about it. Oh, and that it's the land of water. That's about all I know. So this is going to be a very fresh take on experiencing the new stuff. But I was told on Discord that the new character, who I guess is named Lynette, is a quote-unquote free permanent character, like how Kale was for Sumeru. So even though she's on the banner right now, I don't have to pull for her. I can just get her, I guess, which... the invite. Well, there you go. Okay, I guess you just get her. I don't know if you need to reach a certain point in the story in order to be able to do that. I doubt they let a new player just start and immediately get showered in characters, just because why not? But then again, maybe. Maybe that is how it works. I don't know anything about this character. But of course, she's going to have a playtest, so I will touch that. And look, we get two new items. A meshing gear and a loom... These words, we get some sort of new plant. So here's the test run. So we have a few new characters. Well, by a few, I mean the two, the new 4-star and the new 5-star. Looks like Yellen gets a return, and then we have this dude over here. And I guess whoever the third character is, the other 4th-star, 4-star must be like a story-related reward or something, because they don't have a play test. Okay. So then we've got a new story quest, the new origin of the waters, a new area unlocked. I guess, I don't know what this is. Is this a new boss? I guess this is a new boss. I guess that's a new creature. Oh my god, it's a crab. And then that thing. Okay. Oh boy. I'm gonna be a little bit upfront here. I hate having to say this, but my brain has been... treating me pretty poorly the past day, which is why I didn't play anything yesterday. So hopefully Genshin can be my my band-aid like it usually used to be. And I'm very excited. I did get out of bed with the excitement to go and see Fontaine, so that at least should say something. Oh, and... well, shoot, I'll get onto that later. Okay, let's see. We've got the battle pass.
I don't care.
Whoa! What the hell? There's new items? they finally did something new with the battle pass. Uh-oh. Does that mean I have to play it now? Crit rate? What's the difference here? Crit rate? It's got a lower crit rate. I guess this one does different things. Oh, God. That's cool. It's... And then something smells like shit. It's cool, but... I don't even think... Did I ever get at least one of each of these? If I was, like, a super dedicated player, I would have had all of these fully maxed out. Like, refined or whatever. It looks like it's the same type of battle pass as it normally is. And let's see what the hymn looks like. What have we got as our rewards? A very interesting-looking travel notes. What the hell? Just buildings. okay. That's pretty cool. What the fuck stinks? Hello? Something smells. Okay, hold on a minute. I need to see if something, like, died. I don't know. Maybe it's me. Okay. Let's see. We got our login. We got a weekly. Wait, what? Oh, okay. I guess this is from what we did the other day. Let's just carry it over. Some cards there. Let's have a look at our mail quick. Because we should have a whole bunch of shit, apparently. We've got check-in daily, code redemption. I believe this was sent to me on Discord. There was codes as well for like a week or two ago for the game that I tried redeeming. And I swear to you that the person who posted them, I don't know when the codes were actually given out, but the person who posted them, I tried redeeming them not but like 10 minutes after they had posted them on the server, and it said that they were expired. So I don't know if they were just late to posting the codes on the server, or if they really were like instantaneous codes you needed to use the moment that they were released. So just a few extra prima gems, some extra check-in rewards, check-in reward, and then of course the maintenance prima gems, which is nice, and an issue apparently that was fixed, very nice, and a game survey that I'm not gonna worry about right now. Okay, so we can take a look at the new fucking brain. God damn it. Not now, brain, please. Just let me have fun. The new wish. So we've got a new character here named Linny. I'm not sure what the pronunciations are. Liney, Linny, whatever. New 5-star fire character. Oh, Barbara is the other 4-star. Okay. Then we've got Yellen over here. Who, if I was to pull on any of these banners, I would be pulling on Yellen's, probably. Mainly because, so far from what I have seen, although this Lynette character over here is cute, I like her outfit. I really do not like this shit. I don't like this hat thing going on with the Fontaine characters that I've noticed so far, which is probably going to be a huge problem moving forward if there's any new characters that I want from there, but we'll see. Maybe I can learn to like it. And then we've got, apparently, I guess they're a bow user, because there's 2 bows available. And then, of course, the standard banner is going to be the same as it always is. It's telling me about this stuff. There's no new chapters yet. We still don't have any Inazuma-themed stuff. Domains, guide. Okay. Now, I was told that there is something new here. There should be like a new UI thing, but I don't know if they were just talking about, maybe they're just talking about the battle pass having new weapons in it. I don't know. I like how someone is immediately already the new character from that place. I guess I can, I don't know, like let's open up each one of these menus. I know the shop looks the same. We did get these right, yeah. Shop's the same, party setup. Is that new? Whoa! Okay. This is new. Very new, actually. Wow, everybody's got their own like idle animation now for the party setup. What a weird thing to add. I mean, that's not a complaint, mind you. It's like, it's cool. I wonder why they decided to do that. I mean, it's way more stylish. I wonder why it shows Sumeru. Is that just because I'm in Sumeru? Sumeru, whatever. That's cool. I love how the Shogun just looks totally badass. Well, I wonder. I kind of want to look at everybody now. God damn it, I'm going to get so distracted looking at all the characters' idle animation. This must be what they're talking about, because this is definitely pretty substantial here. If that's not it, then I guess you could just tell me in the comments and I'll get to it. Otherwise, I'll probably find it at some point. Oh, shit. I don't think I'm pulling on this. Just, yeah, whatever. Chart course. Now, shut up. Okay. So, I'm going to do the thing where I open the map. Holy fuck, dude. Oh, no, okay, it's only up through here. Oh, wait, no, is it? Wait, where is it? No, that's just the edge of the map. Okay, I guess it's only up through here right now. So that tells me that it's definitely not all released yet. I highly doubt that the entirety of Fontaine is going to be a little sliver of the map here. Wow, it's separated by water. So there is going to be a large amount of water. Because I think I was saying in one of my previous videos that, like, isn't it... Because it's, you know, it's not connected to any of the coasts, as far as I could tell, but I suppose it's going to be surrounded by maybe a giant lake or something. I don't know. Well, that's something we're going to go and check out. It is very small. For this thing being like 60 gigabytes, that's a very small amount of territory from what I was expecting. But maybe I was just expecting too much. It's fine. There'll be more later, I'm sure. Just like how Sumeru... Well, I mean, then again... If you look at the size of Sumeru being like this, it's not really that much different, and this place is fucking huge, not counting the desert and stuff, so I guess it's just the way I'm zoomed out. Don't worry, we will go look at it, though. What is that thing showing up on the side of the map there? What? What is that? It shows up and then disappears. Hello? How do I get it to show up now? I don't know, whatever. Okay. Mino. Oh, God. Okay, sorry, I want to look at these. I want to look at these characters quick. Let's see what they look like. Oh, they actually have like a... They don't just have an animation. They're not just idly standing there. Wow, do they put one of these in for every character? Don't tell me this is why it was 60 gigabytes, because they had to add all of these fucking animations for everybody. Unless these animations already existed. Oh, there she... Why does she
have the fucking... That hat looks so fucking stupid.
God damn it. Why do they have to do this to me? Dude, get the hell out of here. I don't want bugs right now. Got Bennett, Shinyan. Let's see. I forgot what his name was. Toma, I think. Yeah, Toma. Candace. She's got her shield ready to go. Kuki. Oh, I like how she pushes up her glasses. That's cute. But Kaya, what have you got? He's got to use his coin thing. Rosaria. Ningguang. Character I have still never played. Despite getting her in like the first 20 or 30 episodes of the LP. Diluc. You ready to kick ass, I guess. Got your thing going on, Mona. Damn, that was pretty badass looking. Did they add one for Alloy? I guess they did. Venti comes floating and then ding-a-lings his stuff. Amber is ready to go. Okay. Yeah, I think these are... I'm actually starting to think that these are the... Are they? Okay, hold on, let me check. Are these just the character screen animations that they play? Like when you switch to their weapon and then they put them away? No? Maybe? No, maybe not. I guess I'll find out when I select Sucrose. Let's see, where were we? Chi-chi. Okay. Shenhei. Looks pretty badass as well. Yanfei. A lot of characters I've never really played. Lisa. Razor. Official. Officially has a new animation that isn't the same fucking one she reuses every time she talks in dialogue. So maybe they can start diversifying it a little bit. What the hell even is that? I don't know, it's a little dog. Jean. Oh, I didn't realize. Wow, I did not realize that Jean actually had. God damn it. I was trying to move it around. I didn't realize Jean actually has skin. I thought that outfit removed her skin, but underneath her, like, shoulder flappy things, there's a whole bunch of bare skin. Damn. Mr. Cube guy. Oh, I want to see. Yeah, we got to see Xiang Ling here. Damn. It's quite the entrance. Ugh, the good old days, the good old days. Implying that they aren't good anymore. Yeah, these are definitely unique animations from what I can tell. Because I don't ever remember Noelle coming in and then bowing. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Barbara. Beto, and then a bug flies around. Dude, there hasn't been, like, bugs in this room for a while, and now the moment I try to play Genshin, there's bugs suddenly. Oh, whoa, whoa, does she have a tail? She has her tail out! That's so amazing.
Get the fuck out of here, you son of a bitch.
I think I missed it. Uh-huh, I love it. Okay, that's adorable. We're on to our top characters, basically, now. No, it's... I don't know why. It's so simple, yet Sucrose is just so precious. Oh, God. Well, you've seen Cleese. She holds out her little... Yeah, I definitely want to take that, thanks. Ayaka, of course, doing her fan thing. How about Ganyu? We've seen hers as well. Well, I guess we've seen just when she's standing there. We haven't seen her coming in. Fish lady, who's not a fish. And then these other ones we've seen. Oh my god, she swings in. That's amazing. Okay, well, that's all the characters that I own, specifically. It's not every character in the game, but I had to take a look, because, goddammit. Okay, I bet that's what they were talking about, then. I guess I could go through every single one of these, though, like achievements. I doubt there's... No, nothing's new there. Archive. No, it's the same. Character archive, that's the same. Inventory. That's the same. Yeah, that must be it. Quests. Yeah, we've seen the map. It's not changed. Events hasn't changed. Yeah, okay. Well, I guess that means it's time. Let's get everybody ready here. I'm not going into a new territory with... I assume that I can go into that territory without being caught up in the story. But we'll at least be taking a peek at it from a distance. I'm very eager. How fucking weird. Are they gonna... Okay, they better fill this in. Because I swear to God, if they're going to, like, add a territory way up here and then just have random... Unless that's by design, but that'd be... Okay, I finally got the bug. That would be really annoying. They might do it that way by design so that technically new players can walk to the new nations, but they don't want... They want you to have to walk through each nation, you know? So you go from Mondstadt to Liyue to Sumeru to through the desert, then into Fontaine. but this is very bothersome to have this big black area on the map. Okay. Unless that's supposed to be a different nation, but I always assume that Fontaine was right above Sumeru. I don't know. Guess that's something we'll have to wait and see someday. As time goes on very slowly, time just passes and melts away. Okay, let's fast travel. Oh god, we're gonna have to climb that whole thing again. Let's fast travel here. I guess I could. Oh god, you can't even see anything yet because it's on the other side of all this shit. I want to get all the way up to the top if I can. I might want to... What? There's new stuff here? Soul Bell. Huh. I don't remember. I'm surprised I didn't come across that the first time I was trying to run through this place. I am noticing some frame rate issues, which I don't normally see. Unless, of course, I fucked something up when I was setting up the new router. Yeah, that's something else I was doing. I was sleeping, and then I woke up. Oh, it looks like... Oh, wait, why is there a fast travel point way over there? What? Huh? Why is there a fast travel point over there? What? Has that always been there? Did we go over there and get that? Or was that just there automatically? Because new stuff. I don't know. That's weird. Anyways, yeah, I was sleeping and then I woke up an hour or two after the update was live and the servers were up. But I needed to set up a new router or whatever, which thankfully isn't the same issue of changing ISPs like in the past. This is just a new router from the same ISP. But unfortunately, the box doesn't come with instructions on the setup process. So even though I had plugged the router in, my PC would connect but didn't really have internet access or anything because I need to go through the setup process. And of course, it's one of those situations where, because I'm still living, 40 years in the past where I don't have a mobile phone with service on it, you have to have the mobile app to do the setup process. I'm like, I don't have that. Why the hell can't it be, like, at least give me the option to do it through the internet? I know you can do that type of thing through the internet, even without internet access, so that you can set up your new routers. So I had to unplug everything and just put the old router back in until the sun is up, because I couldn't connect with my phone even through Wi-Fi. So I'll have to do that later today or something. I mean, I would have just done it now, but I wanted to play Genshin, so fuck off. Okay, I am going to go here what looks to be the natural direction that you need to go. Hello there, friends. Yeah. I am not here to kill you guys. Actually, you know what? Fine. You want to do this? Then you shall perish at the feet of a child playing hopscotch. Well, I say child. Visually a child. Perhaps in her race, she is a child. But she's vastly older than the existence of my town, so... Grab that. Suddenly light? What the fuck? Okay, there's a fast travel point. It almost looks like there's a cave that you can go through here that'll lead to... where I'm wanting to head. Still waiting for that big moment where we come... Oh, the map has changed. You will sometimes encounter teleport waypoint and domain entrance map points bearing such sub-icons. These symbols indicate that the destination is located in a multi-layered area. After you unlock the corresponding map layer, you can interact with said pins to open the corresponding sub-map. Oh, this is new. Oh, that's what those symbols were. Okay. When browsing map layers, I got it. Dotted lines are not located in the current map layer, I guess. Alright. Additionally, when an area in the center of the map contains different layers that you have previously entered, you can use the layer switching. Yeah, it is. Look, it's just a straight shot all the way over there. That's cool. So we're in an area that has this layer. I guess that's weird. Well, that's just an additional little... That's just an additional little thing to help us. Important massage. Very nice. I guess that's... Wait, God damn it. It's my 200th archive. Entry. Yeah, this feels like the area you'd go to get into the place. Kind of like how Sumeru has that little cave you can go through from the chasm. I just hope there's nothing in here blocking my way. Yes, I could use the fast travel point that's just over there, but where's the fun in that? Yeah, there is stuff in here to collect, and challenges to do and such, but... Well, you know the deal. Depending on what I decide to do today with the game, because it will depend entirely on my mood and how that goes moving forward. So I might play for a little while, I might only play just to see Fontaine a bit and then be done, I don't know. Time will tell, I guess. I'm very hungry, though. That's what happens when you sleep all day and don't eat any dinner. It smells like shit again. Why does it, like, it appears and then goes away, and then suddenly it stinks again? Just a chest down there. It's fine, don't worry, I'll come through this place someday. It'll happen. Just you wait, we're... Oh damn, pretty water. I'm going to ignore you guys. Oh, what, is this a new thing? Morning flower. Is that new? It didn't show up saying new. Do I have that? Because I do not recognize... being here. Apparently I've got some morning flowers. It's a Sumeru thing. Huh. Yeah, this is a Fontaine thing. Oh god, I see one of those new Hillitrolls over there. So I think this is the first time I've ever seen one out in the wild. I'm gonna try to just avoid him. What the fuck? They sound different. That's... I don't like that. Hello? Oh, we're about to come up to Fontaine here. It's in the distance. So first, I'm going to do my playtest quick. Let's get Bennett out of the way. Yeah, of course I would do this. Don't worry, I'm doing it to myself, too. I don't know what I'm doing. Why would I use water on those guys? Okay, I will take a closer look at the new characters, though. Test run. Let's see. So, new 4-star. Cat girl, I think. Lynette's elemental skill allows her to execute an Enigma Thrust, dealing Enema damage. When the skill is held, she'll enter a high-speed pilfering shadow state and unleash her Enigma Thrust when the state ends. Her burst will summon Boggle Cat Box that can taunt and attack nearby enemies. When the Boggle Cat Box comes into contact with certain enemies, it will change colors and fire vivid shots that deal damage from the corresponding element. Okay, oh my god, she's got a huge freaking, like, bow tie on her back. Like, holy shit, look at that thing. Okay, let's see, so she's a sword user. Alright. Oh god. Do I need to say something horny? Look at her butt. Like, that is an interesting skirt thing she's wearing. I'm not really even sure what you'd call that. It's like the legs themselves have their own individual skirts. I'm not sure I've ever seen an outfit like that before. I kind of like it. Okay, at least she's not wearing her damn hat. All right, let's see. So you can hold this down, and she is invisible, I guess. Or you can just place it down. Oh, there's her hat. So it's kind of like, I'm not really sure. Is it kind of, it kind of looks like it works similarly to like Sucrose, her burst. Or you put it down, except it's not like sucking people or blowing them around, but it looks like it's doing, you know, Enema damage, and then sometimes suddenly does a different type of damage. Surprise. Okay. She could be interesting. I wonder what type of character she's meant to be. Alright, well, now let's get the 5 stars out of the way. So this character here, I'm pretty sure we've play tested before, but I could be wrong. I know we've definitely played with her in events before, like the fight, the trial events and stuff. Okay, I'm sure I'll figure it out. It's fine. Just, I call her Dice Lady because she's, right? Yeah, she's the one with the dice. Okay, she's got a bow. She's got a nice butt. That's always important. Okay. Let's see. So you can run. And then water, I guess. I guess, you know, it would help if I actually read it. Which I did not. Huh. Okay. I don't know what this does, but it would help if I would have read it. I don't know what this does. Huh. She could be fun to play with, I guess. If I actually read how she worked and then figured it out, because... Oops, that did not work. Because it would be nice to have a water bow character, because that would mean I could still have a, because I really want to have a bow character in my party regardless, but I could, this would be an excuse to have a bow character that would also do water, which would go well with, well, both of the other characters I've got in my party right now. I mean, I know that I've got Kokomi to do water reactions, but obviously I don't rely on her for damage or anything. I don't know. Well, anyways, let's check out the new 5-star. I guess I'll have to put a little bit of extra effort into reading. Oh boy. Let's see. Forms an aimed shot and pop off a... Oh, right, okay. I think I was told that this character is similar to Ganyu. Prop arrow at charge level 2 and consume HP to obtain surplus stacks. What? When a prop arrow hits, it will summon a Grin Malkin hat that can taunt nearby enemies and deal damage when it leaves the field. Elemental skill consumes the surplus stacks to deal AoE pyro damage. When the duration ends, we'll summon a Grin Malkin hat. Additional, okay, yeah. Okay, got that stupid fucking hat. God damn it. Okay, so we've got cards. Which he turns into, I guess. Interesting. It hurts. It's about one charge. Okay, one charge doesn't. But if I do two charges, it hurts me a lot. So it's supposed to distract enemies, I guess. That's really weird. Interesting. Oh my god, what is this? What the fuck? How did that not do any damage? Excuse me. I don't get it. It's so weird. Oh my god, okay. Well, that's an interesting character, I guess. But I would still probably pull for Yellen, because bias, I guess. Also, she's blue. Okay. Let me acquire my rewards. Oh my god! What the hell? There's even a cutscene. I didn't know there was a cutscene. How much water is out here? I guess I can see how they have a fleet. Wow. So that's what they're gonna do. That's how they'll fill in all of this shit. It'll just be water. Damn, though. How far down does that go, dude? There's a waterfall that leads into a waterfall. Oh my god, okay. Holy shit. Oh my god, this is great. It's so cool to see new stuff. But it's like new territory. It's not, the terrain itself is new. It's like a new type of terrain. It kind of reminds me of the classic Mondstadt stuff. Oh, let's get up our viewpoint here. You know damn well I'm taking a screenshot, so you can shut the hell up. Why do I have mail? Oh, right, it's that thing I didn't claim. Why does it still smell like shit in here? And then a huge bug just lands right on the monitor. What the fuck? Okay, I killed it. Uh-huh, yes. How do I get over there? I guess we have to go down? That's why it sounds like water. Because there's a huge, massive fucking waterfall. There's a wave rider point down here. I didn't realize there was so much goddamn water over here. Oh my god, it's a Hydroculus! Look, it's a new type of Oculus. Whoops, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to start shooting cannons at your port.
How do I get it?
How do I get it? Oh shit. Hydroculus, not a Hydroculus, but whatever. Fuck it. There's people here. Can't talk to them. At least they're not wearing hats. Where did I put my boat at? There it is. Okay, I don't like all this water, though. I'm gonna get back in the ship. The boat. Hello? Oh god, I just got the shivers. Moratime. I didn't see what that said, but it said port of some description. Oh my god, look at this. We got new NPCs and stuff. I guess these are like guards. Yeah, that hat works totally fine. It's not that weird top hat shit. What the fuck is that thing?
I want it.
Wait, what? What the hell? What are you? I guess you're a Malus. I don't know how to pronounce that. Yes. When do we get a playable thing of you? Tell me about the sea.
Observing the sea is my job, and I love it. While I'm around, you've nothing to fear from storms or showers. I'll warn everyone ahead of time.
They have a deep connection to the ocean, so they're like an oceanic creature, I guess. A deep sea. To be honest, I'm not sure if my understanding of the sea's depth is the same at which human beings sense. All I know is diving is difficult for most human beings and requires a heavy set of clothing and a lot of training. Do you know how to dive? It's okay if you don't. I brought these from the sea, and I want to share them with you. Burl conch. Great, now I have a new type of conch. Alright, that's what she sounds like. Or he, I don't know. I don't know if that's a he or a she. It doesn't have boobs. god. Guys. This is incredible. I mean, of course it's incredible. You guys already knew it was going to be incredible. I'm getting this sense of adventure like I would, because I started up my Final Fantasy LPs like I was talking about. Well, I started it up a couple days ago before my brain was like, you know what, fuck you, dude. And this is that sense I get when playing through a Final Fantasy game as well. You come to a new area, a new nation, or a new city, and it's just this, there's NPCs that have new things to say, and it's overwhelming in all the best ways possible. A present? That's right, I've chosen something special from Fontaine to give to my lady love. Curious, I'd hope. All the other sailors hurried off to the court of Fontaine the moment we came ashore. Only I came back here. Sailing is hard work, yeah, but I truly look forward to setting sail once more to see my lady love in Natland. Oh, see, now that we're in Fontaine, we're going to start hearing a lot about the next nation, which I guess is Natland, or Notland, I'm not sure. Notlan, whatever. Is that what's coming next? Is the Pyro Nation? That would be dopamine. She lives, and different tribes come with different rules. Will I be able to integrate smoothly? I don't know. Guess we'll have to find out, won't ya? Bitch. Well, I want to talk to people here because I am thoroughly interested so far in what we're... Oh my god, look at this! What the hell?! It's a dog wearing armor. Baguette. You've gotta be fucking kidding me. What the hell? What did they do to this poor poodle? Good girl, Baguette. Good girl. Baguette is an earnest girl who's dedicated to her work. I'm most fond of her. She's got a truly keen sense of smell. She can sniff out all manner of contraband and prohibited items. No human inspector can beat her in that regard, but... Baguette is tireless at work, and just as tireless when it comes to tearing the house down. If only she could be this at peace at home. Problems at home, I guess. Member of the guards, I guess? Do you need any help? Tell me a bit about yourself. I'm a member of the guards in charge of keeping Maritime Harbor safe. If this place is going to be French, it's going to have French words, and I don't speak French, so... That's going to suck. Oh, I see. It's a place of machina. Don't tell Waka. Excuse me? Hello? What are you? You're way too detailed just to be a piece of scenery. A few people sitting out here. Well, so can I... I can probably, like... I guess I can't swim very far. I can't go to the big waterfall back down there. Marcotte. We got a new plant. It's a pink flower. Pinku flower. Pinkus. Yeah. What is... Oh, that's a ship over there. I didn't... thought there was like a building on the shore. I'll have to check each of these ships out too. In fact, I could do that right now before we go up this thing, because I kind of want to touch stuff. Oh, there is a thing right here I didn't even see. It's a different one. I want to get a photo of this thing. Come a little bit closer, please. God damn it. Oh god, this is really awkward. Where'd it go? Fuck it, I'll just wait for it to come back around. It'll walk back this way. I know it will. Yeah, so I'm gonna jump in my Wave Rider, and I'm gonna go around to each of the ships, see if there's anything at them. And then I guess we'll go up and try to open up the map a little bit, if it'll let me. I'm pretty sure there's nothing that's keeping this place locked away. Like anything where I have to progress through the story to get up here. And even if I did, it's not like there's much story that I need to catch up on, I don't think. Damn it. Why did you... Where are you going? I just want a picture. Damn it. Why the fuck? I just want a picture of you that's not, like, weirdly angled. Ugh. That'll have to do. Okay. Wait a minute. What the fuck? What's happened? Hello? What the hell is this? I'm... Oh no, guys, it's buggy. Now I'm stuck. I'm literally stuck. Are you flipping my dicks? What am I stuck on? It's like I've grabbed onto something. I can't, even it says press X to let go and it's not letting me. Okay, that awkwardly means I'm gonna have to fast travel back. God damn it. I was checking because I'm pretty sure there wasn't a diving animation before, was there? I don't remember, but then again, I've never paid attention to water, so perhaps there always was. Where is... No, that can't be the city. I see, like, a bridge. Whoops! That wasn't supposed to happen. Don't worry, we'll get a shogun back when it... What stinks, dude? And then there's another fucking bug! Arrgh! That is so frustrating! What the fuck? There hasn't been bugs worth fucking shit! Now all of a sudden there's little bugs every 5 seconds! What the fuck are these things? I can't kill them. They're like big turtles. Okay, we checked this boat, because it had the Oculus on it. So, I want to check the other boots as well. Or no, I think it was this boat that had the Oculus on it. Go check the big boots. Guys, these bugs are getting on my nerves. There was no bugs at all, I swear. Even while I was doing the router shit, there wasn't a single bug at the computer. The fuck is this thing? Money. Lots of it, too. This is the edge of the map here. I don't want to... Oh, it looks like some of the ships are off. Yeah. Okay, fine. Fine. The fuck is this little boat here? Can you talk toable? This is such a tiny boat. I say while I'm in my even tinier boat. Wait, can I... Does this open? No. Thought it may be, but it may be. How big is this place? What the f- it's still going. Okay, holy shit. There's another one. That one's pink. The world opens itself before those with noble hearts. Bang. What a weird way to open the map. That is so interesting. Oh, I guess there might be... That might be why they added the... Because it looks like there's stuff underground. That might be why they decided to add that layered map thing. Did light just start flooding from the statue to... What do you mean, what? The water is speaking to me. I feel like I'm using gills to breathe. How about we go back to the desert? Oh, I see. We were joking. Okay. If you can use elemental energy, you can swim underwater. I guess you can't swim even normally. You have to have elemental energy to be able to do that. Yeah, being in the water is scary, 100%. Fontaine's Blessing, gameplay tutorial. A mysterious power that flows out from a statue to imbue you with the blessing of the that source water. You transoceanic, okay. Or ocean? Yeah, oceanic, okay. I'm assuming. Your progress will remain unhindered so long as you are moving through the lakes of Fontaine. Under the protection of the source water, what you expend while moving underwater is not stamina, but aquatic stamina. As such, when your aquatic stamina is expended, you will not drown. You can swim now? I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't like it. So why is it telling me... In Relic Records, Creations of the Hydro Nation, you will need to gather certain types of collectibles. Recommended collection sites will be marked on your map for certain items. Your mini-map will display nearby collectibles when you get close to recommended sites. Before the challenge starts, you have to choose the challenge content through conversations with that person. Resources granted by Leyline Blossoms after challenge completion will depend on the content chosen. The blazing twin-horned crown atop the Emperor of Fire and Iron is a pyro organ that enables mightier elemental attacks and doughtier... What? I'm really confused. It's just pick stuff up. Defeat... Oh, I see. Defeat enemies. Defeat the boss. Okay, it's basically a Welcome to Fontaine event, I guess. Alright, I'll look at that later. I've got fucking bugs, I swear to God, you're going extinct. All of you. Wow. Look at how shitty the terrain looks over there, because it's not detailed at all. You can just barely make out Dragon Spine from here. Urgh. Fucking bug, man, I can't get it. It's like a gnat. It's so tiny. I gotta take a picture of it. You know I do. Yes. A few hundred years old. Well, you know what that means, Internet. Need that pronunciation? That's like, I have no fucking clue what the hell they're trying to say when it's just in text form. Sail to the world's end. Look at how green it is! It's so green! I love how green it is! It's so good to see this shade of green again. Nothing against Sumeru at all, but this green is like a... It's not like that dark, rich green in Sumeru. It's like a... I don't know how to explain that shade of green. It's very similar to the green feeling I got back in Mondstadt. And then there's a boat. Look at all the new people, all the new NPCs. Wait, hold on, there's a thing I can get. Fables de Fontaine 2. She is huge! Oh, well, that's probably because I'm playing the tiny character. Are you a photographer?
Afraid not. I'm good at photography, yes, but I prefer the title adventurer.
You're not doing much adventuring in that outfit. Take my cat on various adventures. This place is... Oh, I guess that's her cat there. This place is really get... No, you know, I'm not gonna do it. Sorry. Nope. I don't want to be that guy that keeps complaining about Star Rail. I was going to start saying this place reminds me of that... I don't even remember what the hell it's called. That one of the first cities you go to in Star Rail, the one in that snowy planet or whatever. That's all that huge city that's built up of like gears and stuff. It really reminds me of that place. Except I was going to say it's already better, but I don't want to go that far and piss off the Star Rail fans. Okay, that's just where we already were. few more characters here to talk to. So can I get another book? Bulletin board. Continue reading. What does the perfume protect you? Massive explosion of unknown origin at the Research Institute, the FRI. How big is this bulletin board? What the fuck? Thank you. Okay, so I can't collect them. Mr. Sawleg. Okay, this is the same thing we already read. Is it gonna keep repeating itself? Fishing Association is looking for line. Okay. I guess it's gonna start repeating itself now randomly. Damn. Oh, bread. Garlic baguette. Oh, don't do that to me, game. I'm hungry. Sure, what do you want to chat about? And then she just rambles on and then doesn't actually chat about anything else. Okay, well, I guess...